The purpose of this brief video presentation is to provide you with information on the identification, biology and damage symptoms in order to enable you to improve control and make decisions regarding fall armyworm. This is the third season that fall armyworm is present in South Africa, and we're still struggling to control and identify it. On the left-hand side here, you can see typical stem borer damage, which most of us are familiar with. And you can see the type of damage is long lesions, mostly in the whorl of the plant, while on the right-hand side, armyworm damage, fall armyworm damage, huge caterpillar-like lesions and holes in the leaves of the plant. It is easier to identify this pest by looking at the plant damage than by looking at the larva itself. Fall armyworm can be confused with several other stem borer species and lepidopteran species at this time of the year in February and March. They all attack plant tissue, but also especially ears at this time of the year. On the top right-hand corner is Bujola fusca, and we can see some small brown dots at the back on the last segment of the larva. Fall armyworm is in the middle of this picture, and here you can clearly see the color differences, the different colors on the larva, and very important, the four big black brown dots on the butt of this larva, and it's got an inverted Y shape on its head. Those are the characteristics of fall armyworm that should be used to identify it. Many fall armyworm larvae hatch from a single egg batch, up to 200 or 300 small larvae, but they immediately start feeding on one another, as you can see in this video that we took, and they all start migrating to the whorl of the plant. Within 7 or 10 days, there will be only one or two large larvae left per plant. It is therefore not good to think of the number of worms that hatch on a plant, but because they are sorting each other out and there will only be a few left after a few days. The life cycle of fall armyworm is like that of any other moth. The adults fly around and they can fly 150 kilometers a night if the winds are okay for them. And then they lay eggs on plant leaves, and the eggs have got this white cushiony appearance, and it can be laid anywhere on the plant. And out of those eggs, the larvae hatch, and you can see the small larvae suddenly migrating and leaving the egg batch, running for cover in the whorl of the plant. The larvae feed on a plant for 14 to 21 days, and you can see a large larvae on the plant here. It has got 2 or 3 days left to feed, and then it will pupate in the soil. The pupa in the soil, depending on temperature, the stage lasts 7 to 14 days, and then moths come out again. Important points to remember regarding identification of this pest. First, look at the type of damage. It's very typical for fall armyworm. In the middle picture on this slide, you can see the Y on the head of the larva, and on the right hand side you can clearly see the four black butt spots of the fall armyworm larvae.